We all know that the Earth revolves around the Sun in an elliptical path. Most of the people believe that summer happens when the Earth is closer to the Sun and winter happens when the Earth is farther from the Sun in its elliptical path. If you are one among them, you are wrong. You might have noticed that the Sun is not rising at the same point in the east throughout the year. It changes its position gradually in the east. But do you know that this change in sunrise location is the reason for the change of seasons on Earth? All of you would have studied that the Earth is tilted 23.5 degrees in its axis. We will look at the reason for this tilt at the end of this video. The Tropic of Cancer is the highest latitude in the Northern Hemisphere, beyond which Earth doesn't receive vertical solar radiation. Sun rays hit the Tropic of Cancer vertically on 21st of June every year. Corresponding latitude in the Southern Hemisphere is called the Tropic of Capricorn. The Tropic of Capricorn receives vertical solar rays on 22nd of December every year. If you look at the map or a globe, you can see these latitudes are marked with 23.5 degrees, which is equal to the amount of Earth's tilt to the vertical axis. When the Earth's Northern Hemisphere is tilted towards the Sun, it gets more amount of solar radiation than that of the South. As vertical rays travel less distance in the Earth's atmosphere, it is scattered less and the hemisphere of the Earth facing the Sun receives more heat energy. It leads to the summer season in the Northern Hemisphere and winter season in the Southern Hemisphere. During the summer season in the Northern Hemisphere, the Arctic Pole continuously receives sunlight for a period of 6 months. If you are staying beyond the latitude of 66.5 degrees north, you can't differentiate between day and night and you will need the help of a 24-hour watch. As Norway is located closer to the Arctic Circle, it is called the Land of Midnight Sun. Same way, summer happens in the Southern Hemisphere when the Sun rises vertically above the Tropic of Capricorn on December 22nd. The Antarctic Circle continuously receives sunlight for 6 months. When this is happening in the Southern Hemisphere, it's winter in the Northern Hemisphere. So what about the other two seasons, spring and autumn? During September, the Sun rises directly above the equator. From September to November, it's autumn in the north and spring in the south. During March, again the Sun rises directly above the equator. Months of March to May are spring season in the north and autumn season in the south. Autumn is the season when plants shed their leaves in preparation for the upcoming winter. Spring is the season of rejuvenation, renewal, rebirth and regrowth. These two seasons are majorly felt in the temperate regions of the two hemispheres. As this changing effect of sun rays is not felt in the equatorial region, it doesn't witness different season and it is warm and humid throughout the year. Duration of days and nights are almost the same in equatorial regions. Now it's time to look at the reason for the Earth's tilt. Earth's tilt angle was accurately measured as early as 1100 BC in India and China. The ancient Greeks had good measurements of obliquity since about 350 BC. Scientists believe that the Earth was hit by a big object called Theia during its initial phases of formation. The impact led to the tilt of the Earth. It also created a big hole and sent a huge amount of dust particles and rubble into space. These dust particles slowly combined to form a satellite planet and we humans named it as the Moon. What would have happened to the Earth if it had not faced that impact? We wouldn't have changing seasons across the year and there will be no season changes like the equatorial region. Thank you for watching this video. For more such infotainment videos, subscribe to Black Story.